So, we just got back from the Outlaw Country Cruise last week, and it was started out to be the best cruise we've ever had. It's a great lineup, and then we lost Mojo Nixon about halfway through the cruise, and he was our afternoon drive guy on that channel. If you've ever, you know, we're here in the city, we don't get a lot of serious because we're not in our cars all the damn time. Well, some of you are, and I think you're fucking nuts. But I'm never going to be that guy. I moved here mainly so other people would drive me around. I could ride the train and shit. But Liz and Mojo was really hard on everybody that's on that channel. And I knew him for a long time. He was the very first show I played in San Diego. Him and the Beef Farmers, all those guys, came out to the show. It was tough, and it was weird. It kind of got us into a different place, and most of that was hard. For me, it threw me into this weird direction during one of my shows that's right in the middle of the show. You know, I guess I felt like something was coming, because it was before Mojo passed away. I don't use set lists these are lyrics up here for stuff I might or may not do later. Depending on how well my glasses are working tonight. But, you know, I suddenly popped into my head in the middle of another song, and I should have been paying attention to what I was singing, that if I didn't play the song I'm getting ready to play, that right then, that night, that I was never going to be able to play it again, because I hadn't played it since before Justin passed away. And it's, there's a moment about this song that I teach in my songwriting course, because it really is when I figured out what this job is, was around this song. I was playing a benefit called the Pass It On Show. You know, there's a chairman, and he invites somebody, and that person invites somebody, and somebody, he invites somebody. There's four of us in that year. Johnny Cash invited Waylon invited me, and I invited Mark Tremino. It's shot the publicity picture, I'll never forget it, because I think I've got a copy of it somewhere. I don't save many clippings, but that one I had to. It's the four of us on the staircase in Waylon's office, and Cash turned around and looked at us. He said, "I'm the only one not wearing black." All of us in black and Johnny Cash in beige. We did the show, and I'd met Cash a few times, but for some reason, out of the blue that night, I played Copperhead Road for an audience for the first time that night, just on a mandolin by myself. And John D. Loudermilk came up to me and said, "Hey, you may have something there, and I know something about them road songs." He wrote Tobacco Road, so. But Cash came up to me, and he said, "You know, I've been meaning to tell you this," and that freaked me out a little bit, because I didn't know that you remembered who I was. It was Waylon that invited me. He said, "You know, that I really like that song of yours, Little Rock and Roller." And I was just went around with my chest puffed out for the rest of the night, because Johnny Cash remembered one of my songs. And then about three nights later, I was on a tour bus and snuck off in the middle of the night because I didn't want to wake all those other motherfuckers up. And I just want to get a hamburger and go back to sleep. And I knew it would turn into something else if they all woke up. So I snuck off the bus and grabbed a burger to go and got back on just as they were topping off the fuel. And just as I was getting on, this truck pulled up next to us, and the guy climbed down, and he said, "Hey, are you Steve Earle?" And that was still a relatively new experience, and I said, "Yeah." And he said, "You know, I really like that song of yours, Little Rock and Roller." And it was like the thing in the cartoon where the light bulb goes off over somebody's head. And to me, it was like, what did this guy, this truck driver, wherever the fuck we are, Kansas or some big square state out west. I don't remember. What do they? Was that guy and Johnny Cash and me? Because I wrote the song. What do we have in common? And it was that we have kids, and we miss our kids when we're gone doing what we did for a living. That's the first time that I realized what this job is about. Nobody gives a fuck about what happened to me. It's about what happened to me that happened to you too. This job is about empathy. That's the gig. And I probably did it before that, but I became conscious of it at that point. And I don't always pull it off, but that's always what I'm striving for when I do this. This is all in the song. Hey, little guy, can't believe you answered the phone. Guess I didn't know you could do that. Lord, help me, ever been gone that long. I'm in a truck stop somewhere.
Bus and everything will be alright till that day.